Can we give God a hand clap of praise? John 19, 26 to 27. I'll be reading a Living Translation. If you have a book that says Bible, you're just fine.
Amen.
It says, when Jesus saw his mother standing there beside the disciple he loved, he said unto her, "Dear woman, here's your son." And he said to this disciple, "Here is your mother." And from then on, this disciple took her into his own home. The word of God for the people of God. I want to talk from a simple subject for the next 5 to 7 minutes. I want to talk about the importance of family.
Amen.
All right, let me hear you, son.
The importance of family. Family may be the most powerful unit in the human organization that God has created.
Amen.
This assertion, some may argue that the church is the greatest organization, but allow me to provide some evidence with this stated claim. When the church functions at its best, it looks and acts like family.
Amen.
The church is composed of many families that work together. When God saved us, he did not save us to become his members. He saved us to become his sons and daughters.
Yeah.
He became our father. Christ is not our pastor. Scripture says he is our eldest brother.
That's right.
This value is clearly articulated as we examine the third word from the cross. In the midst of Jesus' suffering, he stopped dying long enough to take a page from his Jacobean ancestor. He pauses death for a moment and makes a declaration. So I have to ask the question, what is the importance of family? Jesus tonight wants you to know that the importance of family is family handles troubles by coming together.
Bye-bye.
When we examine the crucifixion, we often look at the eschatological impact to overshadow its existential reality. In other words, we often look at salvation that the cross produced, but we gloss over the suffering that it involves. We want to quickly get him up without soaking in his blood-stained rag.
Right.
We know the work of Christ's death, but we easily miss what it means to those who actually watched him die. Let's be clear tonight, the death of Jesus was a state-sponsored act of domestic terrorism. As a public execution that ended the life of a man whose very existence threatened an oppressive and unjust system.
Just like today,
what's going on in the news, today's state-sponsored terrorism, there always seems to be a broken-hearted mother who has to watch her son die. When you see Gwen called the mother of Eric Garner, you see the eyes of Mary. When you see Samarian Rice, the mother of Tamir Rice, you see the eyes of Mary. When you see Leslie McSpadden, Michael Brown's mother, you're looking into the eyes of Mary. There are many other mothers who had to go through the same thing. Let's be honest, you don't have to go through valleys by yourself. We notice in this text, it said the one he loved. He told him, "Behold thy mother." And he said, "Mother, behold thy son."
My God.
That's why verse 27 blesses me, and I'm done. Because the scripture said, the one that Jesus loved from that hour took Mary into his own home.
Yeah.
Watch this. The disciple lost the one who loved him. Mary wasn't the only one who lost something. And then Mary, who lost her son, they came together. Even though we can't fix what happened, we can face it together. They can't do anything at this point to save his life, but at least they can cry like the OJs together. Sometimes you don't need people in your life to give you church colloquialisms and fits and stuff. You just need somebody to face it with you together. I want to continue. That's what you see in the news, people in the streets coming together. People call it rioting, protesting. I call it being together. They even got songs out for it. Kendrick Lamar said, when you know we've been hurt and we've been down before. When my pride was low, looking at the world like, where do we go? When we hate, Popo wants to kill us dead in the streets for show. I'm at the preacher's door, my knees get weak and my gun might blow. But guess what? We gonna be all right. I know that's too much for you seasoned saints, but that's the sentiment, and I'm out of here. Be not dismayed.
Yes, sir.
Whatever betide.
Yes, sir.
Come on, man, I'm ready to get out of here.
Come on.
God will take care of you.
Yes.
Beneath his wings of love abide.
Yes.
God will take care of you. Is there anybody in the building tonight that can say, regardless of the controversy that you deal with, you got somebody that you can go through life with? And that's what's happening in this text. You know something for a surety. And I want to tell everybody, we're going to be all right.
All right. Yeah.